Hi. Hi, everyone. So I'm going to start since it's a few minutes past two. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming today. I'm Moy, one of the main organizers of this event. I'm a member of a grassroots feminist organization based in Japan, and we're currently raising awareness about consent amongst university students. So to give you some background to today's event, this event was organized as part of the Study Tour project, which was put together by Spring, Sexual Assault Survivors and Support Organization, and UK-based Japanese volunteers. And this was made possible by Dr. Otake, who's sitting over there, who secured funding from the Daiwango Japanese Foundation. And the study tour participants are right here from Japan on Sunday, and they're staying here until this Friday. And they're visiting relevant organizations in London to learn about the UK's legal and support system for sexual assault survivors, and to hold discussions. And they'll be making full use of what they've learned in the UK to continue to work towards further reform of the penal code in Japan. So for today, after some welcoming remarks, we'll start with a talk by Jun Yamamoto, the executive director of Spring, and then we'll have a presentation by the research team about sexual violence in Japan. And then we'll take a 10-minute break, followed by Q&A and discussion session. So just from housekeeping notes, there will be discussions about sexual violence today, so if you feel uncomfortable at any point, please feel free to leave. And we will be recording this event, but only the two talks in the beginning, so not the Q&A and discussion sessions. And there will be journalists from Japan who will be writing articles about today's event. They will be taking pictures, but only of the speakers at the front. But if you have any concerns, please let me know. And if you're a journalist yourself and would like to write about today's event, please get in touch with us, because some of our members would like to request anonymity. And finally, I know it's England versus Croatia tonight, but we'll be having a charity fundraising event in East London tonight at a pub called The Castle at 7 p.m. And there'll be live music, dance performance, and there'll be a raffle as well, where you can win Japanese food basket, vouchers for John Lewis and Shushi Makoto, stuff like that. So if you're interested, please let me know. And finally, I'll just hand over to Yuko, who is a postdoctoral researcher at the Department of Medical Anthropology at the University of Oxford, who initially proposed this project and has led the UK-based volunteers.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for coming to our talk event. My name is Yuko Otake. I am a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Oxford, specialized in medical psychology and medical anthropology and cultural psychology. I'm leading this project, the study tour to the UK by sexual violence survivors and their supporters. First, I would like to briefly explain about the reason why I found this project. In many countries in the world, including the UK, sex without consent is legally defined as rape. However, in the Japanese law, if you are older than 13 years and forced to have sex, and if there was no assault or intimidation, it is not acknowledged as rape, but consensual sex. Last summer, Spring, the Association of Sexual Violence Survivors, held a kickoff event, and they began to work towards reforming the penal code in Japan. I was invited as a speaker and asked to give a speech about the UK, the country where sex without consent is a rape crime. After that, Spring members and their supporters asked me, "Is it really true that sex without consent is a crime in the UK? How can you give evidence of the subjective fact that the victim didn't want to have sex, and so on?" I saw that all of those questions are very important and need to be resolved. Therefore, I plan this study tour so that they would meet and hold discussions with legal and health professionals in the UK. We know that sexual violence results from power inequality between different genders. At the same time, we are also aware that there is another power relation between UK and Japan, so-called the developed and the developing countries in terms of gender policy. So it is very important to be sensitive of this power inequality as well. So I would like to ask you, try not to take a savior role, such as we are going to save miserable Japanese victims, or I am teaching what is correct to Japanese people as they don't know better. We do not want a hero, but a fellow with whom we can tackle this issue in equal power relation. The WHO's world estimate of sexual violence in 2013 says that 1 of 10 women has experienced sexual violence in her lifetime. In Japan, according to the census by the Cabinet Office, 1 of 13 women has been raped. However, it is very likely that this is underreported. In reality, probably more women are experiencing rape and sexual assault in Japan. Recently, an increasing number of researchers are conducting surveys on experience of sexual violence among men and LGBT as well. So the policy is gradually reflecting those study results globally. The issue of sexual violence concerns all of us, not only those who have experienced it or those who speak out. You may also realize in your heart, I have experienced sexual violence too. And I think this is very important realization. Me too, I am one of the people who have experienced sexual violence, and I am organizing this project as such a person. Even if you have never been sexually assaulted so far, you might experience it tomorrow. So let us discuss together how we can tackle and prevent sexual violence, as it is such a crucial issue for all of us. And let us think about how we can create a better world where everyone can be who they are and respect each other. I sincerely wish that today's talk event is going to be beneficial for you all. Thank you very much. Now let me quickly introduce the UK-based volunteers who have made huge contribution to this project. Actually, we are a big party, like more than 10 people. If I include all charity performers, we are nearly 30 or more. And some of them are here, so please let me introduce them. So first, let me introduce her, like Mrs. Masako Mahues. She has organized charity events today. So please come around to nearby London Bridge, I think. And Allgate East at 7. So we have plenty of very gorgeous gifts, or like raffle tickets, with raffle tickets. So we really welcome you. And also here is Shoji Maeno, Mr. Shoji Maeno. So she's a really wonderful translator, and produced a lot of beautiful translations with videos and documents. Thank you very much. Finally, I am very grateful for Daiwa Anglo-Japanese Foundation for supporting our project financially and logically. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am the executive director of our group, Spring. Thank you so much for coming today.助成金を獲得し、視察のオーガナイズをしてくださった大竹優子さん、助成大和日英基金の皆様、このイベントを企画し、準備いただいた辻村さんに心から感謝申し上げます。
I'd like to express my special gratitude to people who made the effort to realize this event, such as Yuko Otake, who won the grant and organized this study tour, and Daiwa Anglo-Japanese Foundation, who provided the financial support, and Moe Suzuki, who planned and prepared for this event.
スプリングは日本の性暴力被害者への対応を改善させるための活動をしています。
スプリングの activity is to include how the victims of the sexual crimes are treated.
日本では被害者の人があなたにも責任があったんじゃないのって言われて責められ、適切なケアを受けることができず、一人で苦しむことがやっぱり多いです。
In Japan, what often happens is that the victims themselves are blamed for the responsibility they could have taken or they should have taken, and they don't receive appropriate care and support, and they suffer alone.
性被害を訴える人は少なく、多くの加害者が訴追されていません。
Not many of the victims report the cases to the authority, and many of the perpetrators are not prosecuted.
被害者が恥を感じて沈黙し、加害者が大手を振って歩いている。この状況を私たちは変えたいと思っています。
So these circumstances that you see in Japan where the victims are ashamed, stay silent and ashamed, feel ashamed, and perpetrators walk freely and are not punished, we want to change these circumstances.
そのため政治家や関係省庁に被害の現状を伝えるロビーングを行っているほか、市民の力で変化を起こすためにメディアの報道やイベント、ネットでの広報を通じて性暴力の問題を知り、アクションが取れるように働きかけています。
Therefore, we lobby the government and relevant ministries and make them aware of what sort of circumstances that the Japanese sexual violence victims are experiencing and also educate the general public through the events or the media outlets.And online, and so that we can together take action to address the issues.
私たちスプリングスタ時代は12人で日本から来ました。語ってください。
So we this spring study group consists of 12 members.
はい。市民に性暴力の問題を広く伝えたいと思う報道関係者。
Some of us are journalists from media outlets who want to widely cover the sexual crime issues.
訴えたいと望んだり、弁護法律上の困難を抱える相談者の現状から日本の司法をより改善していけるのではないかと考える弁護士の、すみません、名前を、寺町さん。
寺町です。
And Mr. 寺町 is a lawyer who wants to improve the judicial system in Japan given the legal challenges faced by victims of sexual crimes.
日本はジャーナリスト、塩入り。はい。
My name is Aya Shiori. Nice to meet you.
法律を作成する政治家の立場から性暴力に関心を持ってくれた議員の方。
My name is Yosei.
性被害を経験したことから社会の改善を目指すスプリングのスタッフとその支援者です。
And some of our victims of the sexual crime ourselves who want to improve the society.
私たちはさまざまな民間団体が実施するイギリスの被害者支援や性被害の予防を知り、NHS や内務省を訪問して公的機関の役割を学びました。
So far in the UK, we visited various organizations, including public sectors, private sectors and public sectors such as NHS, Home Office, and learned the support system provided by both private sector and prevention measures against sexual violence and roles played by the public sector.
今後レイプクライシスセンターや裁判所での支援について学びます。この学びを日本に持ち帰り、日本でも被害当事者中心の支援が行われ、連携が進み、法律やシステムがどう変化すればいいのかを提案したいと思います。
We also have a plan to visit the Rape Crisis Center to study the support provided by them and the courts, and with the findings gained during this trip, research trip, we want to promote the changes of legislation and systems so that the police, prosecutors, victim support centers, welfare organization, and private sector will cooperate together to provide support where the victims are centered.
そして何より日本の刑法が性被害の実態を反映したものになるよう取り組みたいと思います。
And more than anything else, we work towards the penal code in Japan that reflects the reality of sexual crimes.
このように皆様にお伝えできる機会をいただけたことに心から感謝し、挨拶に返させていただきます。
I'd like to close my greetings by once again expressing my gratitude for this opportunity to speak with you.
本日、ありがとうございます。それでは本日前半の司会をしていただくジャーナリストの田しおりさんをご紹介します。
I'd like to introduce the moderator who's going to cover the first half of the session, the journalist
Shiori Ito. Hi, good afternoon. My name is Shiori. I met Jun-san and I met Spring last summer when they had a first kick-off event with Modena-san, Otake-san, sorry. And it was great because we witnessed that, wow, 110 years old our rape law can change after such a long time. So it gave us certainly a big hope to make a big next step.And as I think, you know, we are going to discuss today here that even a big change has made last year, there are many things that we have to learn from UK side, learn from outside world, outside Japan, that we have to do more. For instance, you know, which was already have been introduced, that our concept of age is 13 years old, which is still surprising. And there is no idea of consent, which is written in our rape law. So I was invited here today and I'm very happy that I'm here to be part of this. I don't know if many of you have already, I hope, watched it. One of the documentary I made was BBC Two, was aired last, was it already 2 weeks ago, I guess. And it was also,the way to output what we need to change in Japan and what we need to learn from UK and what we can do to bring, learn from here and bring back to UK. So I hope we're going to have a great time today to discuss and brainstorm and hope we can learn from a lot from UK side and also discuss about what we need to change here.So I really want to thank Jun-san and everyone from Spring and who have been organizing all of this from UK. I think it's an amazing opportunity that we ever got. And it's great that we can, you know, outreach from UK to Japan. And that's one of the strongest way to push forward to make some change. And I think Spring has been a great pusher to change, make some change, great changes in Japan. So I hope we all can support them. So let's welcome Spring. Thank you. Please welcome Jun Yamamoto.
ではよろしくお願いします。私は13歳から20歳まで実の父から性被害を受けていました。
I'd like to share the experiences that I went through. I was sexually abused by my own father between the age of 13 and 20.
父親なので脅されたり殴られたりということはなかったです。
He did not threaten me with violence or treat me violently as he was my father.
日本では性暴力とは何か、性被害を受けたらどうすればいいかを学校で教えられることはありません。
Japanese schools do not teach children about sexual violence nor what victims should do if they are victims of sexual violence.
私もショックが強く乖離状態になったので、父からされた行為が性被害だと認識できたのは30代の時でした。
Because of the high levels of shock, I had dissociation symptoms. I simply did not identify what my father did to me as being a sexual crime until I was in my 30s.
日本で私のような被害を訴えたらどうなったのでしょう。
What do you think happens when someone like myself reported this type of behavior to the authority?
日本の法律では13歳以上の女性は暴行脅迫を受けて性交されたケースしかレイプになりません。
Under the Japanese law, if the victim is a female over the age of 13, the crime is only recognized as rape if it was accompanied by violence or intimidation.
私は13歳だったので、しかし13歳で父から暴行脅迫がなかったので、刑法で訴えることは難しかったと思います。
In my case, the abuse began when I was 13, and my father did not use physical violence or threatening behavior. It was therefore very difficult for me to accuse him of criminal acts.
また時効は強制わいせつで7年、強制性交等罪で10年です。
In addition, according to Japanese law, there's a statute of limitation in the case of indecent assault. The crime must be reported within 7 years. In the case of non-consensual intercourse, the time limit is 10 years.
被害に気づいた30代では時効をとっくに過ぎていたので訴えることはできませんでした。
I was in my 30s when I finally understood that I was a victim. It was too late to take legal action against my father.As the statute of limitation has already passed.
昨年日本の刑法性犯罪は変わったのですが、暴行脅迫要件は残りました。
Although the Japanese law on sex crimes were reviewed last year and reformed last year, it remains the case that an act of sexual assault is only defined as rape if it can be proven that assault involved violence or intimidation.
この暴行脅迫要件は抵抗を著しく困難にする程度の、つまり抵抗できないほどの暴行または脅迫があったかが争われることが多いです。
Many argue that the degree of violence or threat was not severe and that in fact the victim could not have resisted that.
そのため裁判官が押し倒されたぐらいでは暴行とは言えない。抵抗できたはずなのにしなかった。ので合意の可能性を否定できないと考えれば無罪になります。
Therefore, if the judge views the holding a victim down with the forces is not in fact an act of violence, or that the victim could not have defended themselves and resisted attack, then accused will be acquitted.
この暴行脅迫要件はとてもハードルが高く、ショックで固まったり怖くて抵抗できない。被害者の現状を無視した考えだと私たちは思っています。
We believe that these requirements are unfair and ignore the reality of the nature of sex crime when victims are often unable to defend themselves due to shock or fear.
2017年の調査では、無理やりに性交された人は女性の13人に1人、男性では60人に1人でした。
According to research conducted in 2017, 1 in 13 women and 1 in 16 men have been victims of non-consensual sex.
しかし同じ年の警察庁のレイプの認知件数は1109件でした。
However, the number of officially recognized rape cases by the National Police Agency was only 1,109.
あまりにも少なく、警察に通報されるのは氷山の一角だと言われています。
The number is so low, we believe that reported sexual assaults are only the tip of the iceberg.
警察に相談しなかった理由として、低年齢であったため、相談することを思い至らなかった 33%。
What follows is the list of reasons why victims did not report their assaults to the authorities. I was so young that I did not think of consulting authorities. That was 33.3%.
警察に相談するほどの被害ではないと思ったから 30.7%.
I did not think the damage was significant enough the warrant consulting authorities. That's 30.7%.
どうせ取り合ってもらえないと思ったから 22.9%。
I was afraid that the authorities wouldn't believe me. 22.9%。
警察に相談できると思わなかったから 26.9% という結果が出ています。
I did not think that I could consult the authorities. That is 26.9%。
この原因は性暴力の教育がなく、訴えていると被害者の周りも思っていない。
The root causes of this situation include there is very little sexual education in Japanese schools. Victims and their supporters do not realize that they can press charges.
性暴力を訴えていいという積極的な広報啓発が不十分。
There is a lack of proactive public awareness campaigning that promotes the possibilities of pressing charges against sex offenders.
性被害を訴えることで近所でネガティブな噂をされる、ネット上でバッシングされるなどの二次被害を受けることがあると思います。
Victims also fear secondary fallout resulting from reporting sex crimes. They worried about gossip in their community, cyberbullying, negative coverage in the press, and so on.
日本の国営放送である NHK が昨年の6月21日にネットアンケートの結果を放送しました。
On June the 21st, 2017, last year, NHK, which is a Japanese national broadcasting agency, announced the results of an online questionnaire on sex assaults.
それは驚くべきもので、27% の人が2人きり練習したら性行為の同意があったと思われても仕方がない。
The results were extremely shocking.27% of the respondents thought that if a woman consumes alcohol alone with a man, she is in effect consenting to having a sexual relationship.
35% の人が泥酔していたら性行為の同意があったと思われても仕方がない。
35% of the respondents said a woman who is drunk deserves to be considered willing to have sex with a man.
泥酔している人はケアの対象だと思います。
Surely, if a person is too drunk, they should be treated, looked after, not assaulted.
私の周りはそう考える人が多いのですが、日本の一般常識としては、性行為における同意とはどういうものかがまだ分かられていないと思います。
Unfortunately, this view is not shared by everybody.
同意とは、同意の有無、対等性の有無、強要性の有無で判断されるものです。
The question of consent is a key issue in the definition of sex crimes. Whether or not consent was given, whether both parties were equal, whether or not the consent was coerced.
Yes, equal consent. ではなく、年齢、成熟、発達、レベル、経験に基づいて提示されたことを理解していることが前提です。そして、歪んだパワーやコントロールがないか、強要性はないかなどを判断することが大事です。
It is important to ascertain, in addition to the actual age of the victim, their level of maturity development. This is necessary in order to ascertain whether or not the victim was aware of the nature of the sexual assault, a sexual act, and to judge whether any consent involved disproportionate levels of power or control.
しかし日本ではまだ性行為における同意が一般常識にはなっていません。そのため、どうぞ。
In Japan, the concept of sexual consent is not yet widely understood.
そのため司法運用でも同意があったかではないかではなく、裁判で有罪になりそうなケースかという指定で判断され、無罪になりそうなら落とされていくということが起こります。
Consent is not the focus in many prosecution cases. The likelihood of a conviction is seen as top priority, and cases tend to be dropped if it is thought that the possibility of conviction is low.
まず警察に訴える人がそもそも少なく、レイプされた人の 3.7%、強制わいせつも含む性犯罪を受けた人のうち、警察に訴える人は 18.5% と言われています。
In fact, the number of reported sexual assault is very low to begin with. The rate is only 3.7% among rape victims and only rises to 18.5% when indecent assault cases are included.
そして日本では警察官のみが裁判所に訴える起訴ができますが、 2016年の起訴率はレイプが 36.1%、 強制わいせつが 40.1% です。
In Japan, only prosecutors can proceed to court, but the prosecution rate in 2016 was only 36.1% for rape and 40.1% for indecent assault.
日本の警察官は 99% を有罪と思わなければ起訴しないと言われており、裁判で争うことができるケースはとてもこう少なくなってしまいます。
Unless prosecutors see a 99% chance of conviction, they're unlikely to prosecute an offender. As a result, the number of cases brought to court is extremely limited.
このような司法運用の結果、性暴力の多くが裁判で有罪にならず性犯罪として認められない。
The result of such judicial management as follows.Many acts of sexual assault are not recognized as criminal acts, and the rates of conviction at courts are extremely low.
日本の有罪率は 99%。 警察に送検しても検察官が無罪になりそうな性犯罪を起訴しないのではないか。
So the Japanese conviction rate is 99%. If the prosecutor does not see that chances are high, then they drop the case.
その結果、起訴されない性犯罪を捜査することに警察が消極的になる。
As a result, police are unwilling to investigate sexual assaults that are not likely to be brought to court.
警察の窓口で相談を受け付けない。よくあることだから捜査は難しいことですと言われる。
They often tell the victims that sexual crime is common, but difficult to investigate. They tend not to accept consultation.
そしてなぜか日本の性犯罪の起訴率は下がり続けています。被害者にとって自分の被害が裁判に送られないということは、法的にあなたには性被害者ではないというふうに言われたも同然であり、大きなショックを受けることです。で、下がり続けた、どうぞ。
For some reason, the prosecution rate of sexual assault in Japan is decreasing. If charges are not brought to court, they can still reject itThey feel that they're not officially recognized as victims, which is extremely upsetting.
下がり続ける理由を法務省に聞いたのですが、意図的にやっていることではないと言われ、理由は分かりませんでした。
We questioned the Ministry of Justice about declining prosecution rates. The response was that such a decline was not their intention. We do not know the actual cause of the decline.
このようなことになっているそもそもの原因として、判断の根拠となる刑法が性暴力の実態に合っていないのではと私たちは考えています。
We believe that the root cause of this current situation is the penal code on sexual crimes. The code itself does not suit the nature of sexual assault.
裁判官も警察官も法律に基づいてそれぞれの仕事をしています。その法律が時代遅れで実態に合っていないのから裁かれるべき犯罪が裁かれないのではというふうに思っています。
The penal code is the backbone of the judicial system for judges and prosecutors, but the current penal code on sexual crimes is so outdated that many offenders are not brought to justice.
私たち一般社団法人スプリングはこの現状を変えるために性犯罪の実態に即した刑法の改正を目指して立ち上げた団体です。
We established Spring on July 7th last year.Our mission is to reform the penal code on sexual assault so that it more accurately reflects the true nature of the crime.
イベント、研修、メディアを通じて市民に性暴力の問題を伝え、こういうことっておかしいよねという市民の声を議員や省庁に伝え、日本の状況を変えるために働きかけています。
Through events, trainings, and media,We aim to educate the public on issues of sexual assault. We lobby the government and policymakers in order to make them aware of the need to address the current situation in Japan.
どうしてイギリスに来たのか。お伝えしてきたように、日本では同意のない性交ではなく、暴行脅迫がないとレイプにはなりません。
Why did we come to the UK? As I said earlier, in order for an act of sexual violence to be defined as rape in Japan,It must be proved that the act involved violence or intimidation.
昨年の刑法改正の時に、私たちは暴行脅迫要件を撤廃し、同意のない性交を性犯罪にしてほしいと 要望しました。
When the Penal Code on Sexual Crime was reviewed last year, we demanded that such requirements should be abolished.
その時、
And that any sex without consent should be recognized as a criminal act.
その時に言われたことは、同意という証拠に残らないことを立証することが難しい。
At the time, we were told that proving whether or not consent was given is very difficult, whereas violence is easier to prove because it's visible.
暴行があれば傷が残るので周りから見て分かりやすい。
So the violence is easier to prove because of scars and injury.
イギリスでは同意のない性交を性犯罪とした結果、有罪率が下がったということです。
In the UK, since non-consensual sex has been classed, non-consensual sex has been classed as criminal offences, the conviction rate has declined.
しかし私たちは同意のない性交をされることが性犯罪であり、被害者を深く傷つけることだというふうに考えています。
But we believe that the sex without consent is a sex crime and is deeply damaging for the victim.
一方、有罪率が下がり、加害者を有罪にできなくなることも問題とも思いました。
On the other hand, it is also an issue that offenders do not get convicted and the conviction rate drops.
そのため、不同意性交が性犯罪というイギリスの法律を学び、どういう運用されているのか、加害者が罪を免れるような現状がないのかを知りたいと思っています。
Therefore, we would like to study UK laws that define non-consensual sex as sexual crimes and how the authorities deal with sexual crimes.
そして市民の皆さんが同意のない性交を性犯罪と認識しているか、例数したら同意と思うのかも知りたいと思っています。
We also interested to learn from more about the public views on sexual crimes in UK. Do UK citizens recognize if this someone's too drunk, is it considered to be that considered that the person has given consent to sexual act?
Spring は日本の東京での活動が中心ですが、共に活動する仲間を紹介してくださったり、仲間になってほしいと思っています。
Our activities are predominantly based in Tokyo, but we are also looking for partners to team up with.
次に行きます。はい、はい、一緒に議員に会いに行ったり、調査研究に協力したり、イベントを開催したり、あなたの力が必要です。
We need your support when we visit lawmakers, conduct research and hold events to share information with the public.
またスプリングが刑法改正に向けた活動をするために、この1年で80万かかりました。
Over the past year, our effort to bring about the reform to the Penal Code on Sex Crimes required 800,000 Japanese yen.
今後さらに全国に向けた活動をするために資金が必要です。
In order to continue to expand our efforts, we needed more funds.
ぜひ会員になり応援していただければと思います。
We'll be extremely grateful if you consider becoming members and support our cause.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Jun-san. I believe some of the research was so shocking for some of you. For instance, 27% thinks it's sign of consent if you go and drink alone with a man.I can go to the pub now, that was the idea. And 35% if you're drunk, that's the sign of consent. I was thinking about the last Saturday when you had England versus Swedish game, and everyone was drunk on a train, and that's scary to think about. That's the idea of consent, isn't it? So now, I'd like to welcome...Dr. Otake and Dr. Saito, who are co-principal investigators of research team on what consent means for women in Japan. Please welcome Dr. Saito and Dr. Otake.
今は日本語
じゃあ今からはちょっと日本語でお話をさせていただきます。Please let me speak in Japanese, my mother tongue. So she's going to translate into English. So, 日本の女性にとっての成功同意とは、今の話で、今のジュンさんの話で、同意というのが日本人にとっての同意は、私たちにとっての同意とはどうも違うので、どのように同意が起こっているのか、この日本の文化の中でというのを、ナラティブをもとに調査をしてみました。
So we conducting research understand the difference in, between the concept that we have in the UK and the concept that's been shared as, or regarded as very common or norm in Japan through the narratives.
Yes.
So,
と私たちは、そうですね、まず私と斉藤さんが、2人で、共同責任者としてこのリサーチを進めています。で他 の, リサーチチームのメンバーは、主に何人いるんでしたっけ。大体10人くらいいます。ここに並んでいる、ユニバーシティの 人々が、協力を一緒にして入れさせています。この写真の方々です。それから今ジュンさんがリードしている、スプリングも、一緒にコラボレートしています。
Spring is also collaborating as a partner. This is led by Jun Yamamoto, and they're collaborating, working with us.
はい、そうですね。例えば、この調査自体がまずスプリングとのディスカッションに基づき計画されました。
This research itself is planned and organized based on the discussion that we have with Spring.
それからスプリングは私たちの調査結果についてのメンバーチェックを実施しています。メンバーチェックというのは分析の結果を当事者の経験が適切に反映されているかどうかということを当事者からチェックしてもらうものです。
スプリングメンバーは同じメンバーチェックを実施しています。これは the results and outcome of the research is analyzed by the member of the Spring and to make sure that
International Health Congress at Oxford 2018というのがありまして、学会で発表をしてきました。
We participated in this event called International Health Congress in Oxford, which was held 2 weeks ago, and we had presentations.
はい、ポスターがそこにあります。
は
い、興味のある方はぜひ休憩時間にでもご覧ください。
では、斉藤に代わります。先ほどからお話のありましたように、日本の刑法では、被害者が抵抗できないほどの暴行または脅迫が必要で、不同意性交だけではレイプということにはなりません。
Earlier by Jun-san, the legal definition of the crime of rape in Japan requires the use of assault of intimidation sufficient to make it impossible for the victim to resist. Sex without consent alone does not constitute rape.
これも先ほどお話にありました通り、当事者や支援者は暴行脅迫の要件について撤廃を求めましたが、刑法学者たちは、先ほどの話の通り不同意性交はでは証拠が立証が難しいと、暴行脅迫が証拠であると。で、検察庁や裁判所は暴行脅迫のないレイプであっても状況に応じて正しく判断ができているという主張がありました。
Therefore, the survivors and supporters ask forAbolishment of the requirements. However, the opposition claimed that sex without consent is subjective judgment by the victims, and also the prosecutors and judges believe that they are familiar with the reality of rape through
この点には日本の文化的な問題も関わると思います。日本では目上の人に明確な不同意や拒否を示すことは良しとはされません。で、特に性交に関しては明確に同意を求めるということはなく、さらに女性は明確な拒否を示すことが難しいです。では、明らかにしたいと思ったことは、暴行脅迫のない不同意性交はどのようにして起こるのかということです。また日本の女性は逆にどのようにして性交に同意を与えているのかということを明らかにしたいと思いました。でそのために、私たちは、今回は調査の初期データの分析です。調査はまだ継続しています。で初期の26名の成人女性のインタビューとウェブ上の直筆の語りをデータとして用いました。でその26名は当事者団体の方々や専用のウェブサイトがあるので、そこで応募してくださった人、紹介を通じた方、リクルートです。分析の手法はテーマ分析というナラティブを分析する手法を用いています。またインタビューの過程で性暴力の当事者の方を傷つけてはいけないので、 WHO のガイドラインに準じてトレーニングをしてインタビューに臨みました。
In order not to upset the victims, or the interviewers, we conducted this research according to WHO guidelines.
これウェブサイトの一部です。
This is part of the website.
で結果です。
These are the findings.
レイプというのは大変日常の中で起きているということが分かりました。
One of the findings is that rape happens in everyday setting.
で、今回は主に5種類のレイプの、方が見出されました。
We also identified, the five main types of, rape.
で最も典型的な不同意性交のパターンは、エントラップメント、被害者を陥れたり追い込んだりして起こるレイプの形でした。であとは飲酒薬物を使用してのレイプであったり、目が覚めたらすでにレイプをされている最中だったといったような奇襲型のレイプ、で児童期の性虐待、で親密なパートナー間のレイプ、これらは分かれているわけではなく重なる時もあります。でエントラップメントのタイプについて詳しく説明をしたいと思います。これは、見知った人でも見知らぬ人でも同じプロセスが起こります。まず、日常生活の中でこう上下関係を作り上げるんですけれども、 それは会話とかやり取りの中で、加害者は自分の価値を被害者に対して高めて権威づけ、さらに被害者を貶め上下関係を作ります。上下関係のある中で物理的に逃げ道を塞いで、例えば薄暗い場所とか角とか車の中とかっていう死角に追い込みます。また、例えば普通の会話の中に突然彼氏いるのとか処女なのといったような、性的話題をすり、性的話題にすり替えをします。そして、被害者がひるんだり弱ったりしたところに性交を強要します。この中で被害者はすでに逃げられないという状態が作り上げられます。さらに、加害者が顔見知りの場合はこのプロセスが、簡単に進みます。
This process is more simplified if the perpetrator is someone that the victim is known.
例えば、顔見知りの場合はすでに加害者は被害者よりも社会的地位が高いので上下関係がすでにあります。
So there's a disproportionate power relationship already built because he's already of a higher social standing than her.
また、被害者の加害者に寄せる好意を利用することもあります。また、女性は、従順であることや人間関係で波風を立てないということが良しとされています。顔見知りだと余計になのでノーと言いづらいです。これは不同意性交 の, 一人の女性の語りです。例えば、路上でアンケート調査で声をかけられてそのまま性交の強要に追い込まれました。相手は年齢が上で、途中から相手の方が、権威を示し始めます。権威を示し始め
ます。
ちょうど先生と生徒みたいな感じの会話になります。そして、その被害者が生徒みたいな状態になったところで暗闇に連れ込みます。そして彼氏いるのとか答えづらいことを聞いて被害者が口ごもってうつむいているところで犯行に及びました。
And he asked her about things that she wasn't really feeling comfortable to answer, such as whether she had a boyfriend and she stumbled, then forced to have.
Quite shocking episode, and but it's not just one case, so a series or number of episodes as such. で、日本の、で今度は良い方のポジティブな方のお話です。
We also identified positive outcomes.
そう、つまり女性がどのようにして成功に同意を与えているのか、
Which is how Japanese women give consent to sex.
そう、何人かの女性は、被害を受けたことは過去にあるけれども今は、愛のあるセックスも経験していると言いました。この結果はもしかしたら皆さんにとってはノーマルすぎることかもしれないのですが、つまり日常生活の中で尊重し合う対等な、関係がすでにある。そしてその尊重し合うコミュニケーションがずっと続く中で、愛のあるセックスに、が起こるというふうになります。この例えばですね、このエピソードがその、同意を与えた良いセックスの例になります。日常の何気ない、仕草や、会話の中でも主従関係ではなく、対等な関係が築けているということを言っています。それが性生活、セクシャルリレーションシップにも及ぶということを言っています。つまり日本人のカップルであっても、日本人同士のカップルであっても、日本の男性と女性またはさまざまなカップルであっても、このようなリスペクトに基づいた成功が可能だということも分かりました。はい、結論として私たちが主張したいことはこちらです。男性、つまり、大切なことは男性が性交に及ぶ以前の日常的な関係性や、接し方を、ちょっと日本語が変ですね、接し方を どのように持っているかということが、実は女性が同意や不同意を与えられるかどうかといったことに左右しています。
So what is important is that before sex, how women treat and build relationship women in everyday life is important and itMakes difference on whether or not the consent is given.
今回の調査は、女性だけがパーティサパンツだったので、参加者であったので、男性女性というふうには、男性が加害者パーペチュエーターで女性が被害者という仕組みではあったんですけれども、このような結論になっています。
During this very first phase of research, all the respondents happened to be women. So in these experiences, perpetrators are all men and victims are all women. But these are the findings that we gathered from this research so far. Mm-hmm.
じゃあ私たちのリサーチのリザルトに基づいて政策提言をしてみたいと思います。つまり成功に至る以前の上下関係の構築があったのか否かということが、実は性暴力を規定する重要な要因であると言いたい。
So whether there was an equal power relationship before sexual intercourse needs to be taken into consideration.
そうですね、したがってこのことが刑法改正の議論において、考慮されることが極めて重要であり必要であるということを提言したいと思います。な
のこの上下関係は、事件以前からの顔見知りかどうかではなく、顔見知りでない場合にあっても同じことが言えます。で、今後、さらあのまだ調査は継続中なので、上下関係が作り出されているプロセスをもっと詳細に、研究明らかにしたいと思っています。
As I said earlier, we're still in the middle of research and we'd like to explore and to find out more detailed processes through which a disproportionate power relationship are established.
また飲酒薬物の場合にもそもそも飲酒や薬物を飲まされるというプロセスにも問題があると思っているので、そこも明らかにしたいです。
We also like to look into the process where the women or the victims are forced to drink when we study the impact of alcohol or drugs.
また何人かの人は過去の性暴力被害の影響で抵抗ができない、不同意、抵抗ができなかったということを言っていたので、それも調べたいと思っています。
We also look into some experiencesby the, some of the victims. Some of the victims.
当事者の声が反映された法律、当事者の声が反映される社会を目指していきたいと思っています。ご清聴ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you so much, Dr. Otake and Dr. Saito, for sharing such an important and interesting research. And yes, I believe Japanese idea of consent is a lot to do with cultural and social background, but also it is a lot to do with law. And I hope you keep continuing with more research, because I think hearing from Japanese women are the key to solve these things. So, well...